To New Caledonia, where local media are reporting one person's been shot dead as violent protests rage on in the French territory. France is now sending in extra police, with more than 130 people arrested during the riots against plans to change voting laws. It's also inviting New Caledonian political leaders to Paris to discuss the proposed reforms. Kushla Norman has the latest.
New Mia, waking up after another night of fiery unrest. Rioters defying the curfew imposed by France on its territory. Dozens of cars have been torched and property set alight in the past 2 days.
Violence is neither justifiable nor tolerable. Violence has never forced anyone's hand. It has never enabled dialogue. And it is through dialogue and dialogue alone that we will find a global political solution for New Caledonia.
The violence was set off by a plan to give more French citizens voting rights. Indigenous Kanak people fear it will water down their independence movement.
We don't agree with that law, with the text that they have laid there.
But 10 time zones away, the bill was passed, albeit with a concession that France would withdraw the plan if talks took place.
It was a pressure tactic by Mr. Macron to encourage discussion locally. But even despite this gesture by Mr. Macron, at the end of the day, I think tensions were mounting so much that things just got out of control last night. And sadly, we haven't seen this sort of violence since the early 80s, the bad old days.
That conflict ended with a deal that confined voting to Kanaks and migrants living there before 1998. France's plan to expand this criteria would mean 25,000 extra voters.
The independence leaders want to be sure that it's going to be people with long-term connection to France. And they also want it to be New Caledonians to decide.
France wants to keep the peace with New Caledonia. It's a major nickel producer and part of France's strategy to up its influence in the Pacific. The invitation now open to New Caledonia's leaders to head to Paris for talks. Kushla Norman, One News.